ஸ்ரீமான் வெங்கடநாதாரிய கவிதார்க்கிக கேசரி வேதாந்த ஆச்சாரவரியோமே சன்னிதத்தாம் சதாகிருதி நமோ நாராயணா. அடியன் ஹஸ் பீன் என்ஜாயிங் த நவராத்திரி, த கொலு அண்ட் த மோஸ்ட் வண்டர்ஃபுல் தர்ஷன்ஸ் இன் த நவராத்திரி கொலு. And especially Adiyen always gets enchanted and excited by the Krishnan Bommais, the Kutti Kannan or the Govardhanagiri Krishnan or the Krishna majestically and beautifully standing with the hands on the hips or with the flute in his lips or with Gopikas or a little Kanna being tied down to a mortar by Yashoda, or Yashoda with the stick and the quivering lips with the tears welled in his eyes, or all these wonderful wonderful darshans are the most beautiful images to behold in our eyes and contemplate whenever time permits. Kannan itself is the most wonderful name. Kannan ennum karum devam, Andal says. Andal is so much in love with Kannan, and the if you take all over the world, the Krishna Bhakti, the personification of the entire world's Krishna Bhakti from time immemorial is supposed to be Shatakopamuni Swami Nammalvar. That much was his Krishna Bhakti. So you see, Shatakopamuni was so much in awe or love or bhakti, intense devotion on the Kutti Kannan or the Krishna, that he went automatically into the Nayaki Bhavam, and he has enjoyed Kannan in Nayaki Bhavam in so beautifully as Parankusha Nayaki. And Kangulum Pagalum Kantuiradiyal Kannanir Kaigalalirikkum Sangu Chakkaram Enne Kaikoopum Thamarai Kannenne Thaval Thalarum. So Sangu Chakkaram Endru Kaikoopum, the moment somebody says Sangu Chakkaram, she folds the hands. And Kangulum Pagalum Kantuiradiyal Kannanir Kaigalalirikkum, the tears that's coming out of her eyes, she can push the waters, kaigalal iraikum, which are overfilling, and it's flowing around her. And such was his anubhavam, and he went into the mystic form as Parankusha Nayaki because of the handsome beauty of Kannan. And even Srimad Bhagavatam, the moment Krishna was born, the moment Kannan was born, Bhagavatam starts off saying that Tamadbutam Balakam Ambujekshanam. The Ambujekshanam, the lotus-eyed Krishna. Tamadbutam, it's most wonderful, most Acharyabhutam. Chaturbhujam Shankha Gadar Yudha Yudham. With the Shankha Chakra Gadai, with Panchayudhams, he was born. Srivatsa Lakshmam Kalashobi Kaustubam Pithambaram Sandra Payoda Shaubhagam. Srimad Bhagavatam says he was with Pancha Ayudams. He had the lotus eyes. He had four chaturbhujam, four arms. And he adorned himself with the Sankha Chakram, the Gadai, the other, all those Pancha Ayudams. The newly born child had Srivatsam mark on his chest, and the kaustubam around his neck, the gem was in his neck. The beautiful, handsome, dark, blue-hued, sweet baby had a golden yellow pitambaram around its waist, and the dark blue cloudy like the farm Divya Trimeni was so wonderful to behold with the pitambaram. And the Vasudeva saw the curly black tresses of hair from Krishna. So tamadbutham balakam ambujekshanam chaturbhujam shankha gadar yudayudam. Thus one cannot be satisfied with Kannan's beauty. Those red coral lips, those large, charming, well-laid, spread-out eyes, the creeper-like nose, and the little smile from his lips, and the curly tresses on his crescent forehead, there's no match. And one can see that the small palm, red lotus-like palm, all these things completely stupefied and maddened Shatakopa Muni. Yettiram uralinodu inaindirinda engiya elive. How did you, Sarveshwara, Paramatma, Paranjyoti, how you stoop down such a saulabhyam? You tied yourself down by that illiterate cowherd mother Yashoda. Yettiram, he swooned for 6 months. That anubhavam was there in chaste, sweet Tamil in Thiruvayamali. And we have been enjoying this Thiruvayamali Nalayar Divya Prabandhams. And Swami Desikan himself enjoys that Thiruvayamali. And it seems in Thiruvahindrapuram, he saw Rajagopala Swami, Krishna, and Swami Desikan, of course, with the equal bhakti as the Alvars, if not more. Swami Desikan himself enjoyed Kannan as the Nayakan, and he becomes the Nayaki in the Nayaki Bhava. And the Desikan Nayaki enjoys the Gopala Vimshati, the 20 verses on Kannan, the Gopala. And these verses are, though they are simple, very easy, very nice to recite, and it's a lilting meters. And Swami, in these 20 slokas, the rasikas enjoy the desikas Nayaki Bhavam, the waves that emanate or arise out of his mind when he was enjoying the Kannan. One can visualize the Krishna as well as Desika's enjoyment of Krishna, the Leelas and the Jalakrita, the Rasa Leela. It's an amazing 20 verses on Krishna. It Adiyen's greed and fools rush in where angels fear to tread. Adiyen's greed to get into this Gopala Vimshati, to enjoy this Gopala Vimshati, the ocean of enjoyment of Desika on Kannan, just by standing in the shore of Gopala Vimshati and enjoy. Even Vyasa, sage Vyasa, when he had the dhyanam on Brahma through the Kalyana Gunas of Brahman in Stotras, Swami Desikan clearly establishes that in Adhikarana Saravali of Vyasa's Thiruvullam, the mind, through Adhikarana Saravali, and in the last sloka, Swami calls himself as Nigamacharya Nama Munindraha, like Nammalvar, Shatagopan, Maran, because of the Nayaki Bhavam, because of the Dhyanam or contemplation on Krishna in Nayaki Bhavam. Swami Desikan declares or addresses himself as Munindraha and introduces himself as Munindraha, as the Nayaki, like Shatakopa Munindraha. So Swami, our His Holiness Sri Paravakote Andavan Sri Gopala Desikan Mahadesikan, in in 2004, he had released a wonderful book, Gopala Vimshati, in the series of Vedanta Desika Stotra Vyakhyana Mala. This is the second book after Hayagriva Stotram. And Swami, as per the Ajna of His Holiness Dr. V.N. Vedanta Desikan, has beautifully compiled. He is Navaneetam Vedanta Desika Acharya. And thus, like Navaneetam, the Vennai, he has compiled so beautifully the three great Vyakhyanams, and he has blessed us with most wonderful commentaries. And it is Adiyen's Bhagyam, opportunity or fortune, to go through these and attempt to understand something and make little justice, to put it in the crude English language, though Adiyen is disqualified to at least share this enjoyment on Kannan, the enjoyment of Desika on Kannan, and make sure that we all are blessed with Krishna Bhakti and are blessed with the mind to focus on Kannan Kadalini Nannum Manamudayargalagi, to focus the mind towards the Kannan's lotus feet, and thereby we can contemplate on the most esoteric, the Ashtakshara Mantra, and be blessed with eternal enjoyment, immersed with Krishna Bhakti. And what else is required other than this in our lives, here as well as there? Kavitarkika Simmaya Kalyana Gunashalini Srimathe Venkatesaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha. Sriman Venkatanatharya Kavitarkika Kesari Vedanta Acharya Varyome Sannidattam Sadahruti. Hare Krishna, Namo Narayana. We'll continue. And yesterday we talked about the introduction session of Kannan Anubhavam through Swami Desikan's Gopala Vimshati. Today we will enjoy the first verse of the most delectable Gopala Vimshati. Vande Vrindavanacharam Vallavi Jana Vallabham Jayanti Sambhavam Dhama Vaijayanti Vibhushanam. Such a simple verse. There are 21 verses in Gopala Vimshati, including the last verse, the Palashruti. So Vimshati means 20 verses on Gopala. It is reported that Swami did not name this sloka stotra as Gopala Vimshati. Somebody else has named it. In fact, in the whole Gopala Vimshati, there is no place where he has addressed the Lord as Krishna or by any name, and only adjectives, gunas, and his leelas have been enjoyed by Swami Desikan. Swami Desikan has so beautifully immersed himself in Krishna Bhakti, and through the excellent and extensive usage of gunas, kalyana gunas, his leelas, Swami has portrayed the childhood leelas and pranks of Krishna, and it's so enjoyable that this Vande Brinda Vanacharam slokam is also the first slokam of the wonderful Kavyam, Mahakavyam Yadava Abhyudayam. And Sri Appaya Dikshitar has written commentary on this Yadava Abhyudayam based on the instruction or order of the king by name Chinnadimma Rajan. This Mahavidwan Appaya Dikshitar has written a wonderful commentary, and it seems the first sloka itself, Vande Brinda itself, was so deep and extensive that he wrote pages after pages of commentary on this. We will also enjoy some glimpses of this commentary in this verse. Swami says this, the avatarikeya of the commentary talks about the Sri Vaikuntha Nathan, who is there in Sri Vaikuntham. Vaikunthe tu pare loge Shriya Sardham Jagatpatihi Astya Vishtu Rachintyatma Bhaktai Bhagavatai Saha. He is there along with Bhagavata, with the Nitya Suris, the Paratvam, Sri Vaikuntha Nathan, but he does not enjoy being there, in the sense he loves to be on the earth with us, and there his saulabhya quality, sausilyam quality will not be exposed or glorified, will not shine there. And hence also there was a vyajyam, or under the pretext of Deva's pleading for Ravana Vatam, he took the avataram to show his sausilyam as Rama. And Dadascha Dvadashe Mase, for 12 months he was in the womb of Kaushalya, and he was born as the Dasharatha Kumaran, Kausalya Putran, and Sri Ramachandra Murti. And he, in that avataram, without any seeing any status or position, he mixed with the karadi, the monkey, the deer, the hunters, the everyone, and nirantra samslesham, he mixed and united with almost everyone in the forest, in the monkeys, and Sugriva's samrajyam, Sugriva's army. Thus, however, he only mixed with the leaders of this gang, but not with the lowliest people, and he was not satisfied. Even though Yerai, Yedalan, Kilmagan, Yenadi, Yerangi, Matravar, Kinarul, Suranda, Trimangayarva says, the way he hugged Hanuman, or the way he mixed himself with Guhan, Sugrivan, Vibhishanan, even though it's there, however, he was not very happy, satisfied with his sausilyam qualities. That's why he took the avataram as Krishna. And there, even the Rajyadigara Yogyata is not there. There is no way he could become the, because of Yayati Shapam, he could not become the king. Avirashit Yada Pracham Dishinturiva Pushkalaha, like the Purna Chandran that comes in the east, he was born as Vasudeva Devaki's son. And he was such an effulgent little baby. And that is why Swami Desikan swooned, he was so enchanted by the Cheshtitams, by the birth of Krishna, by the Leelas of Krishna. And the more and more he started enjoying Namalvas Thiruvayamali, the more and more he started enjoying the Gokula Parikshaditara Chanam in his mind, when he was contemplating that Anubhava Janita Niravadika Preeti, he immersed himself in Krishna Bhakti, Krishna Anubhavam. And because of that, the love, the intense love, he became, it grew manifold in his mind, and burst out with this wonderful poems, Vande Brindavanacharam Vallavijana Vallabham Jayanti Sambhavam Dhama Vaijayanti Vibhushanam. And if we take Ramanuja, even Ramanuja was so much in love with Krishna. Shemanal Vidum Purulum Dharmamum Shiriya Nal Kamamum Yenrivai Nanganban Nanginum Kannanuke Amadu Kamam Aram Purul Vidarki Enruraitan Vamanan Shilan Ramanushan in the Manmishaye. There are four Purushartham: Dharma, Artha, Kama, Moksham. Everybody would say the best is the Moksham, the last one. However, for Ramanuja, it is only Kama, desire, love. And we all will be shocked to hear this. However, his love, desire, bhakti for Kannan is ultimate for him. And that is what is Dharma, Artha, Moksham lead to is Ramanuja's declaration. On similar lines, our Ramanuja's Amsham, Ramanuja's avataram, Swami Desikan himself immersed in Krishna bhakti, and hence Vande Vanangigire, bowing down to, paying obeisance to Krishna. And here he does not say any name, he does not say Aham Vande, he only says Vande. Nathayaiva Namapadam was the way he started off Dashavatara Stotram on Krishna. And to him I bow, and this Jayanti is the Shimma Shravana Avani Masam Krishna Paksham Ashtami joins with Rohini Nakshatram. In that he took the avataram as Kannaviran, and that Jayanti called Sri Jayanti Chaitra Sriman Ayam Masaha Punya Pushpita Ghananaha Chakravarti Trimahan. And he was born in Chitrai, and Krishnan was born in Avani. And this Jayanti Trivavataram is only for Krishna. Others are referred to as Narasimha Jayanti, Vamana Jayanti, Varaha Jayanti, like that. Whereas Sri Jayanti is only for Krishna. And Swami, and Jayanti Sambhavam. Sambhavam means the connection with Jayanti, that's all. And Swami never said as the Pujyokti. Swami says as Samanyokti. He just puts it as a matter of fact, Jayanti Sambhavam. Because if you say as a glorified Jayanti, then it would mean that he is a Paratvam. He is a Supreme Lord. Krishna would not like it. And hence he says he just was born, he was connected with Jayanti. Jayanti Sambhavam. And hence he put it as a matter of fact, ordinarily. Similar, like Alvar said, Pirandavarum, Valandavarum. In similar lines, Jayanti Sambhavam. And Brindavana Charam. Brindavanam Charam means how he walked in Brindavanam. How nicely he enjoyed Brindavanam with Gopa Gopikas. How nicely he walked down with his Gopas in Brindavanam. And in Brindavanam, Swami, even Andal says, Ittamana Pashukkalai Inidu Marithu Neerootti Vittukkondu Vilayada Brindavanate Kandome. How nicely this Brindavanam, Brindavanatil, he was there. He was not satisfied with Nitya Shuris in Sri Vaikuntham, and there like that Shuttunan Malaigal Tuyana Vendi Vinnorgal Nanni Ratti and Dubam Dara Tara Nirkave Ange Yitiya Vennai Toduvanna Pondu Imilatuvan Kuttidayadane Kutta Adalayardam Kombinuke. When the Nitya Suris have bathed Sri Vaikunthanathan, have dressed him up, Alankaram is over, and then they are now starting Shuttunan Malaigal Tuyana Vendi. They bring the huge, nice, wonderful garlands, and then they come to Sri Vaikunthanathan to adorn him. They are bringing the Sambrani, and then when the Sambrani smoke was incensed and it was shown to Perumal, smoke was there everywhere. When the smoke disappeared, Perumal also disappeared. He is not there. வெரிசி ஈட்டிய வெண்ணை தொடு உண்ண போந்து இன் ஆர்டர் டு கன்சியூம் அண்ட் ஈட் அண்ட் பார்டேக் த வெண்ணை ஃப்ரம் கோபிகாஸ் ஹீ கேம் ஸ்ட்ரெயிட் டு ஹிஸ் கோகுலம் அண்ட் தட் இஸ் வாட் ஹீ லவ்ஸ் தட்ஸ் வாட் ஹீ இஸ் ஹாப்பி ஆஃப் சிமிலர்லி இன் பிருந்தாவனம் காடும் மேடும் கல்லும் முள்ளும் கரிய திருமேனி வாட குடையும் செருப்புமின்றி சஞ்சரித்து கொண்டிருப்பவன் He never, he didn't have chapel, he didn't have umbrella. He used to just walk with his friends of Gopas in Vrindavanam. And that's what he was enjoying. The Gopas and Gopas' parents, the entire Gokulam was so much in love, adoration with Krishna. Divattilum pasunirai meippu uvatti. Alvas enjoy how much he loved the cows, the calf, the cattle, and how he played flute and he was guiding them to mow and to eat the grass and ittirithi pashukkalai meithukkondu marithu neerootikkondu ishtamana pashukkalai inidu marithu neerootti vittukkondu velayada Vrindavanathe kandome and how he guided the cattle to go to nearby pond how he bathed them, how he made them drink water, how he took care of them lovingly, how he enjoyed doing that. This Vatsalyam was so beautifully referred to in this Vrindavana Charam. Mm-hmm. And the way this Vrindavana Charam, that one word is so beautifully, and when he is there walking down with in Vrindavanam with Gopas, where he enjoyed being there, being with them, and that's what Desika was in love with, and that's what Desika lost himself in. That's Shaushilyam and Vallavi Janavallavam. Kandrigal meitte tan tholarod kalandu varuvanai therivil kande yendina mulayum en vashamallave. When Krishna was coming back from Vrindavanam and he was walking down the streets of Gokulam and he was from the forest, he is walking back in the evening and around 4:30, 5 o'clock, the sun, evening sunset, and on that, when Krishna was having his hand on the shoulders of his friend, of the Gopa, and then he was walking with all others and he is so dark, handsome, cute, sweet, and he was looking at every house where who is looking at him, and all these gopikas, they were simply enjoying his coming there, and they had transformation in their body. Periyarvar Tirumali 3.4.4, it talks about how they lost themselves in that. Kundredutte anirai kaathapiran kovalanai kulaludi udi kandrigal meithu than tholarode kalandudan varuvanai therivil kande endrum ivanai opparai nangai kandariyen edi vandu kaanai ondru nilla valai sulandru thugilendila ila mulayum en vashamallave. And the bangles just fell off. And even my body, my breast, my sthanam do not belong to me anymore. Thus, they were in complete love, adoration. And they loved him so much that niradishiya priyatvam minjavanna kadal tanmai grew in that gopikas, that they were ready to forego their relations, their parents, their spouses, and they wanted to come and unite with Krishna. That was their adoration. Pati Shudanya Bratru Bandavan Ati Vilankyate Achudagataha, Srimad Bhagavatam says, Minjavanna Kadal Thanmai. Like that, he became a Vallavi Jana Vallavan. Like Sri Vallavan, like Bhuma Vallavan, like Goda Vallavan, Neela Vallavan, He became Gopika Vallaban also. Jayati Teyadikam Krishna Janmana Vraja. So that Gopika Gitam is also from that Vallavi Jana Vallabam. And Arivandrumillada Aikulat Pengaludan Kalandavan. And Sarveshwaran, Sarvarakshakan, Sarvajnan. In spite of that, he mingled with this Arivandrumillada Jati Gunam, not at all equal to matching to him. And because of that, Jana, Desika says, Gopi Jana, ordinary gopis, Vallaban, and Dhama, Divyamangala Vigraham, Tejomayamana Divyamangala Vigraham, Dhama, Tejas, Jyotis, Jyotisikalam Jyotis, Param Jyoti, he is, and his Tejas, Ayar Kulatil Tondrum, Mani Velakke, Ani Velakke, and he, when he was there in the womb of Devaki, she was shining, glowing. Vasudeva knew that it's going to be a divine child. And Adiyen Jyoti Uruvai Angvaiti Ingu Pirande, says Thiruvaimani. That Jyoti is there in Sri Vaikuntham as well as in Gokulam in now. So Divyamangala Vigraham Param, Swayam Prakasha Divyamangala Vigraham, and this Dhamma Shabdam refers to Divyamangala Vigraham. Dhamma Shabdam refers to Vibhavavataram. And Vande Gunair Dashyam Upagataha, like Lakshmana told Rama, Gunair Dashyam Upagataha, I am enslaved by your gunas, Rama. Similarly, being enslaved by the wonderful gunas of Kuttikannan and the childhood pranks and leelas of Kuttikannan, Swami says, Vande, like Namalva says, Aramude Adiyen, because of the Saushilyam, Dasoham Koshalendrasya Dasaha. Thus, he starts off with Vande. In fact, when we enjoy our Apaya Dikshita's Anubhavam, there he says Vande, which means it's the present tense, means always. I vanangiren, now I am bowing down to, now I am prostrating, now I am paying namaskaram. So whenever we say Vande, which means now, which means continuous, sada sarva kalam, so it is eternal, and hence Vande. And this is one. And also bhakti purvaka vandam, vandanam. This is not like sharanagati, which is done only once. This is enjoyment, anubhava bhakti, and hence Vande. Also he says in the last verse, we are going to say when the vastra abharanam says anjalin yachamanaha in the last verse, and there he begs anjali from Gopikas. Now there is no begging. I am going to tell you before you beg. Swami Desikan says Vande. And this Brindavanacharam, this slokam talks about Vatsalyam, Saushilyam, Saulabhyam, Swamitvam, everything. The Brindavanacharam being with Vatsam, being with calf, cattle, itself is Vatsalyam. Vallavi Janavallavam, being with Gopikas, and that is Saushilyam. Jayanti Sambhavam, the avataram as the Gokula Krishnan, and that is Saulabhyam. Vaijayanti Vibhushanam, having the Vanamali, and that Vanamali itself is Vaijayanti Vibhushanam, is the Swamitvam. Because when it is talked about Vaijayanti Vibhushanam, it refers to Sankha Chakram, including the Vaijayanti, the Vanamala. The Vanamala are the flowers that was collected in the forest. Thus, his Charitam is Adbhutam, Veera Shringaram. His Jayanti Sambhavam is Veeram, victorious, valorous. Vallavi Janavallabam is Shringaram. Brindavanacharam is the Adbhuta Charitam. Thus, this Vande, Brinda, Vana, Vallavi, Vallabha, Jayanti, Vaijayanti, the Shabdalankaram, Anuprakasham, is the enjoyment, Ape Dikshita says, Vande, Brindaha, Vallavi, Vallabha, Jayanti, Vaijayanti. And that's the way one needs to enjoy, says our Apaya Dikshita. So, it's a wonderful verse, great compilation. There is no place Swami mentions about Krishna here. All only adjectives. You need to guess whom it talks about. There is no doubt. Absolutely, it's the one and only Krishna. Hare Krishna, Kavitarkika Simhaya Kalyana Gunashaline, Srimathe Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha.
Sriman Venkatanatharya Kavitarkika Kesari, Vedanta Acharya Varyome Sannidattam Sadhakriti. Namo Narayana, Hare Krishna. We are enjoying Kannan Anubhavam through Acharya Sarvabhauman, Sri Nigamanta Mahadesikan's emotional bhakti, aparimita bhakti, anubhava bhakti, and anubhava janita aparimita bhakti from Swami Desikan through Gopala Vimshati. Today's verse is verse number 2. Vacham nijankarasikam prasami kshamanaha vaktraravinda vinivejita pancha janyaha vannatrikona ruchire varapundarike badhasano jayati vallava chakravarti. So this verse, the essence is that Kutti Krishnan is now growing, the baby is growing. So the verse talks about somewhere around, we can say 3 months to a year and a half or 2 years. So a year and a half. So that's the timeline this verse refers to. So when the Kutti Krishnan is so sweet, so divine, so effulgent, so cute and so handsome, the parents are worried that there will be evil glances cast on the baby, on the sweet baby, and hence they want to protect through Rakshaka mantra. So they called their guru Garga Maharishi, and then the Brahmins have protected through Ashtatala Padma Asanam. And then inside they drew a triangular mantra, and they drew a triangle, and thereby after placing Krishna in that column, and Trikona Ruchire, Varna Trikona Ruchire, Varapundarike. So when they place in that colorful triangular formed the beautiful mantram, and on that rangoli there is a Ashtatala Padmam drawn, and on that Krishna was kept in that cradle. So in the cradle there is a drawing or column with the protected mantram enshrined in that to protect the Kutti Krishna. So, and this is once before placing Krishna in that cradle, in that yantram filled cradle, she keeps Krishna on her lap and she takes the small shankh, the white shankh, and pours the milk in his coral curvy red lips. So she is feeding him the milk, and While she feeds, we all know the babies don't show and drink naturally, automatically on their own accord. They don't do. You have to divert and focus their attention by making some sound. So she gives Krishna, Khanna, Kanaya, Kuti, all that. She addresses him and she also tells story, Ramayana story. She tells about Rama, about Sita, about Lakshmana, about Bharata, about how the Ramayana was enacted. So she was narrating, and Krishna with his wide open eyes looking at her and her lips to listen to his name. So Nijanka Rasikam. So because the words that come out of her bear his name and it has full of rasam, the sweetness, he listens vacham, those words, prasami kshamanaha. He looks at her, the words, he listens to it with happiness, with joy, with excitement. So he gets excited about listening to his own stories, words, names from her mouth, and pays attentively and focuses on that. Bhaktra Ravinda, in that Aravinda, the red lotus-like lips, in that Vinivechita, kept Panchajanyaha, the Shankh, which is like a Panchajanyam, which is the white conch shell, is kept on his red lotus lips. And Varna Trikona Ruchire Varapundarike Baddhasana, after drinking this milk, she places him on that Varna Trikona Ruchire Varapundarike. She places him on that cradle which has this Ashtatala Padmam, the eight-petaled lotus flower-like asanam on which the column is drawn in a triangular colorful form with Gopala Yantram, and that is to protect the little baby. The baby, generally our human babies are to be protected, but not Perumal himself who has appeared, but that is because of their Pungum Parivu. That's because of their extensive love for Kutti Krishna. They are worried some evil glances will be cast on them, and hence they protect through this Gopala Yantra. This mantra is Gopala Ashtadasakshari, 18 Akshara Mantra. This Kleem Krishnaya Govindaya Gopi Jana Vallabhaya Swaha. This is for Samanya Shishu, this is the Raksha Mantra. For Pirumal Shishu, this is because of their unconditional love on Kutti Krishna. And this month Akshara Mantra, 18 Akshara Mantra, I've just repeated from the commentary written by Sri A.V. Gopalachar Swami and written so beautifully by Dr. V. and Vedanta Desikan Swami. It has got Bijakshara Mantra. This mantra, Gopala mantra, is enshrined in this verse. So if you recite the verse, that itself yields excellent benefits and alleviates all the fear in you, protects all of us. And this is also there in Gopala Tapaniya Upanishad. This mantra needs to be learnt at the feet of Acharyas and Mantra Siddhi scholars, erudite scholars, and hence this is only for just sharing. And Swami here says, Baddhasana Jayati Vallava Chakravarti Varna Trikona Ruchire Varapundarike. This has got multicolored, and it is drawn as a triangle, and it simply captivates our mind the way it's drawn, and the red Ashtatala Padmam lotus flower is kept And the way Krishna is kept, Manikam Katti, Vairam Yidai Katti, Anipunnal Seida Vanna Chirutti, Peni Unakku Piraman Vidutandan, Manikuralane, Talelo, Vayamalandane, Talelo. After placing in that cradle, Yashoda sings the Talelo, and when she makes that Talelo using her tongue, sings this lullaby. Krishna looks at her tongue, listens to that sound, listens to the music, and then slowly closes his eyes to sleep. And that is why, and in that vanna chirutottil, this kolam is drawn, rangoli is drawn, and Krishna is kept there. And Krishna just doesn't just like that sing, listen to the song and sleep. He is so naughty. Sometimes he sits there, sometimes he stands up, sometimes he jumps out, and so it's very difficult to manage him. And எடுத்து கொள்ளில் மருங்க இருத்திடும் ஒடுக்கி புல்கில் உதரத்தே பாய்ந்திடும் மிடுக்கில்லாமையால் நான் மெலிந்தேன் நங்காய் சேஸ் யசோதா. யசோதா சேஸ் when I take him கிடக்கில் தொட்டில் கிழிய உதைத்திடும். When Krishna is kept in the cradle, he kicks the cradle so much that even the cradle gets sometimes that stems are broken. And kidakil tottil kiriya udaitidum. So the Yashoda thinks that probably he doesn't like to be in the cradle. So she picks him up. And eduthu kolgil marunga iruthidum. The way he hugs her and tightens her, and it pains her. Marunga iruthidum pains her waist. Odukki pulgil udarathe paindidum. She tries to control him and tame him. Then she places her feet, her small, cute, red lotus-like palms on her chest, on her face, and tries to jump to the ceiling. And so udarathe paindidum, midukillamayal, she is unable to control. Midukillamayal naan melinde nangai. I'm thinning down because of lack of strength and being unable to take care of this baby who is so naughty. And Badasano Jayati, and the way he sits in the cradle on that Gopala Yantram, it is simply mesmerizing, overwhelming, stupefying, and enchanting and exciting all those who come to see him. Kannayum manadayum kollai kondu jayati vetriyodirikiran kannan, says Acharya. And it's got lots of meaning. Baddasano jayati vallava chakravarti. He is a chakravarti. He is a small baby, he is glorified, looked at as if he is the darling king. And so everybody and the whole cowherd gang, cowherd folks, the entire Gopikas, they all come to see him. The Nandagopan himself is the king. He is the darling of Nandagopan. Obviously, he is a Chakravarti. So when we have a small baby in our house, that baby is treated as the ultimate, as the king in the house. And nobody should do anything, any harm, any scold on that baby. When such is the case for human baby, what to talk of divine baby? Nijanka rasikam, and vak, nijanka rasikam vacham. This has got another meaning. They say the vak devatai, Saraswati, is also in disguise as a gopika and is standing in the corner looking at Kutti Krishna. She doesn't want to miss this opportunity because Vak Devata is his daughter-in-law, Chaturmukha Brahma's spouse. So she wants to enjoy Kutti Krishna, her father-in-law, in this form. So she looks at him and she also kunjifies him and calls him endearingly. And she, Krishna, looks at her and the walk. Nijanka rasikam vacham. That's one interpretation. Another interpretation is that Saraswati herself, as a baby, sits in the lap of Krishna, the baby Krishna. And that's also another version interpreted by Acharyas. So, like others, Saraswati is also enjoying Kutti Krishna, and he sees her enjoying, and he also enjoys Saraswati looking at her and addressing him endearingly. Thus, the Thai, the Yashoda, has placed him in that Baddhasana, in that asana. And that's the meaning, Jayati. He is the one who grants victory to all of us. May he conquer my mind as well, says Desika. May he makes me victorious. May he facilitate me to focus my mind uninterruptedly, unconditionally, with full of bhakti, paragnana parama bhakti, to this Kutti Kannan. And this Gopala Yantram is so nicely enshrined in this verse, and this Vallava Chakravarti, the Gopa Gopika's Chakravarti, is being celebrated, glorified around, and this Kutti Krishna's enjoyment is unmatched, unparalleled for us to continue to enjoy. Kavitarkika Simmaya Kalyana Gunashalini Srimate Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha.
Sriman Venkatanatharya Kavitarkika Kesari Vedanta Acharyavaryome Sannidattam Sadahrade Namo Narayana. We are enjoying Swami Desika's Gopala Vimshati. We had started this series of Kannan Anubhavam. Kannan Leelais, Kannan Childhood Pranks, Kannan's Cheshtitangal. We had started this through contemplation and enjoyment of Acharya Sarvabhauman Swami Desikan's Gopala Vimshati. Today's verse is number 3. One of the most beautiful verse. Amnaya Gandhi Rutita Spurita Daroshtam Asra Vilekshana Manukshana Mandahasam Gopala Dimba Vapusham Kuhana Jananya Pranastananda Yamavaimi Parampumamsam. It's a wonderful verse. Last verse, where Vacham Nijankarasikam, there Yashoda keeps Krishna on her lap, the Kutti Krishnan, and feeds with the shank milk into his red lotus-like, coral-like, beautiful lips and the mouth. So that is one. And he says, Jayati Vallava Chakravarti. Jayati, he remains victorious, and as a Vallava Chakravarti, as a Mudizuda Mannan, to among the cowherd folks, he is a Chakravarti. And these two are still in Desika's mind when he goes to the next verse. And hence, immediately, the feeding the milk and the Chakravarti reminded him of Putana. So, the Putana, we all know, the demon who was sent by Kamsa to finish Kannan off. Look for this baby. I think it is growing up in Gokulam. Just find out and finish Kamsa's instruction. So she came. When she came, of course the parents were also quite protective of the baby. So there was always somebody to engage Kutti Kannan and take care of him. And So now the infant baby Krishna was kept in the cradle and it is looking at the entrance. And fortunately or unfortunately, at that time there was nobody and nobody around. So Putana comes in, enters Putana, and Amnaya Gandhi. Amnaya means Yo Vedamcha Prahinoti Tasmai. He is the one who taught Veda to Brahma. He is Pitaka Vadai Piranar Brahma Guru Vagi Vande. So his, even this breath, Krishna's breath is Vedas. And when such is the case, Amnaya Gandhi Rutita Spurita Daroshtam. The upper lip and the lower lip, because when Putana came in the guise of Yashoda, she took the form like Yashoda. She took the form of the mother and then she came in front of Krishna. Krishna Kannan is looking at the entrance. And the baby knows that because he is Sarvajnan, Sarveshwaran, Sarvarakshakan, Lord. He knows, he is omniscient, he knows everything. So when he looked at Putana, he knew exactly what her intention was to finish him off. And so he starts crying because he wants milk now. When the mother sees the baby crying, she takes him in her arms and starts feeding, breastfeeding. So similarly, the moment he saw her, she was in disguise, in Vesham, and hence he also takes the Vesham. He also starts enacting. If you come to play, let me also play. He starts playing and she thinks he has been cheated to believe that she is the mother. And she sees him crying and now she thinks he is sincerely crying. He got deceived that I am Yashoda, and hence she comes closer. When she comes closer, Spurita Daroshtam, that upper lip and lower lip are quivering. When he cries, both the lips are quivering, and we can enjoy Perumal Thirumazhi Kulasekar Azhvar. Same, he says, Alugayum Anji Nokkum Annokkum Anikol Sen Chiruvai Nelippaduvum Tholugayum Ivaikanda Ashodai Tholla Inbathin Irudhi Kandale. This we will enjoy in another verse, but I just thought of this. Alugayum Anji Nokkum Annokkum Anikol Sen Chiruvai Nelippaduvum. And that uncontrollable tears from the eyes. Anji Nokkum, and he is scared. And Sen Chiruvai Nelippaduvum, that little beautiful curvy kutti choppu like that mouth, lips that start quivering. Spurita Dharoshtam, and Asra Vilekshana, Asra Vila, Kanneerudan Kalangiya Kangal. As if he is sincerely, he is hungry and he is looking for the mother's milk, and in order to make Putana believe, he starts crying so much. Asra Vila, Vila Anukshana. Anukshana means the moment, Anukshana Mandahasam. Anukshana, the moment she saw him crying and she comes closer, now she gets scared whether his crying would stop or not when she picks him up. So she is worried, because if he continues to cry, everybody would come in. Yashoda and Nandagopan, everybody would come and she would be caught. Who are you? They will know. So she's scared. The moment he sees her getting nervous, and then his mission is not accomplished to finish her off. So he starts smiling. Mandahasam. He's changed. And he smiles at her because she comes closer and she looks into her eyes and starts smiling. The moment she starts smiling, Putana now begins to get convinced that Krishna has really believed that I am his mother. What an actor. And this guy completely misled her. One who had come in disguise has been deceived. She came to cheat him and he has already cheated her. So deceived her. That smile completely enchanted Putana and she simply hugged Krishna and took him in her arms. Gopala Dimba Vapusham, that Gopala Shishu, Gopala Dimba Vapusham, Kuhana Jananyaha. Kuhana Jananyaha means she came in the guise of mother with a deceitful intention. Unmail pay, but she has come as Thai. So Thai Uruvil Vanda pay, Kuhana Jananyaha. Pranastanandayam. This is the adjective. So, the one who sucked pranan from the breast milk, through the breast milk. So, he started sucking her breast milk. While he did that, he sucked her life itself. And he is not an ordinary child. She was deceived and she started breastfeeding him. And immediately, he started drinking both the milk and the life. And Kuhana Jananyaha Pranastanandam Tanandayam Avaimi Param Pumamsam. Param Pumamsam Avaimi. This is a beautiful line given by Desika. And our Vyakyatas, commentators have enjoyed this. Avaimi Param Pumamsam means I have realized, I have understood, I have known, I have comprehended that he is Parabrahma, Paratvam. This Krishna who has sucked the milk along with her life as Gopa Shishu has become Paratvam, has been understood as Paratvam by me. That's what Swami Desikan says. We may think that he has given compliments to himself, that he has understood that Krishna is Paratvam from this. But Yashodai, when she feeds with love, with affection, with adoration, with vatsalyam, she doesn't know that he is Paratvam. She knows that he is only her darling baby, Krishna. So she hugs him, she kisses him, and she gives the milk. And when Putanai gave the milk, she also didn't know that he is Paratvam, he is Sarveshwaran. She just gave milk with an intent to kill him. But Desika says, I didn't realize his saulabhyam, his sausilyam of mingling even with such Gopika, such Yashoda. And instead, I have embraced his Paratva quality and distanced myself from the Lord, from Kutikanna. What a stupid I am. Alvar says in Valavel Ulagil, Thiruvaimuli, Emberumanudaya Paratvatai Kanda Agandrar Pola. So in Valavel Ulagil, he says, I have distanced myself looking at his Paratvam. And Annalanudai Uruvanai, Nanugumam Avane. So, Annalanudai, the one needs to know the Shaulabhyam, and that quality we need to understand, and then we need to go near him at the back of our mind, thinking of his Sausilyam and Shaulabhyam. And that's what is required. So, even Trimange Alvar says, Avvannattavar nilamekandu thozhi avarai naam devarendru anjinome. In Thirunadanandagam, avarai devarendru anjinome. He He is Paratvam, He is Sarvajnan, He is Sarveshwana. And we got scared with that. Atmana Manushammanya Ramam Dasharadatmajam. Endru sonna Perumal Vartaye Kelamal. He said, I am an ordinary son of Dasharatha. Don't call me this, that, all that. I don't know who I am. I am simply a son of Dasharatha, says Rama. Instead, Bhavan Narayano Devaha, Chaturmukha Brahma said, I listened to him and I thought he is Paratvam and I distanced myself. Nanum Yangal Appullar Arulichedana Sarveshwaranudaya Paratva Matratai Arindu Agalugayale Narathaman Endru Per Petru Pirandu Kettanai Kattilum Idaichigalai Pola Vivegam Illai Agilum Shaulabhyathai Arindu An Nalanudai Oruvanai Nanugumavane Endru Engira Vaarthai Namakku Vendiyathu. So we should not distance ourselves thinking of his Paratvam, thinking of his Swamitvam. Instead, we should behave like Gopa Gopikas and think of his Saulabhya Sausilyam and see that he is our Kuttikannan. He would mingle with us because he is such a Saulabhyam, and hence there would be close proximity and intense devotion with him. And instead of listening to Gopa Gopikas, we listen to Valmiki. And this Valmiki, who said he is Jagat Guru, he is Stanyam Tat Vishasammishram Rasyamasi Jagat Guruho. So, and that's what the Rishi says. And we believed him and thought that he is Parampumamsam, Avaimi Parampumamsam. And hence, I have unnecessarily thought of him as Paratvam. Oh, how stupid I am, says Swami Desikan himself, that one should enjoy his Saulabhya Sausilyam and enjoy Krishna Anubhavam through that. Kavitarkika Simhaya Kalyana Gunashaline Srimate Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha. Krishna, 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 Sarvam Krishna Arpanamastu. Hare Krishna.